Hi, everyone. Thank you for joining us. I'm Marc. I am a web developer who focuses on real-time and live interactions on the web. This is David. He's our business developer and 360 film technologist. This is Gene. He is our VR technologist and software engineer. And this is Abhishek. He has previously founded three startups and focuses on design and product. Together, we have worked on a lot of projects together. We've built robots, and we've built 360 projects, VR projects, and live web projects. But we're here now to show you Svrround, which is a live 360 social platform. So why don't we show you a little bit of what we've been up to?
Totally with live shows, you need the energy. That's the great feedback. Pretty sure I will merge live and like interaction with the virtual interaction.
Being able to speak to my audience and see what they're feeling, what they like, what they don't like, and being able to engage with them in this new way. Because usually when you're on stage, it's about energy and it's about feeling what these other humans are feeling and trying to pick up on what they're doing and how you're making them feel. But now it's like the feeling is still there, like you're still emoting, you're still expressing yourself, but people can relate to you in the comfort of their own home and in this new digital way, and it's really cool to have that.
I want it to be, oh, I can't come out, but I have the option to be there in my room. I just gotta pay for it. And I want people to, I still wanna value and treasure real human interaction. The people who follow me in Germany on SoundCloud or South Africa, like, oh, you guys want to see my performance? There you go, here's the link. Our fans, they're our evangelists. They're the ones that sell this shit. Like, I'm I could be the catalyst. I could be the starting point, but they're the ones that keeps it going. So if they can mostly interact with each other, if you present something to somebody and they really like it, they'll feel like, what was I doing before this? And I want to be linked to that concept, that idea.
We began with a simple hypothesis. The people are constantly looking for new ways to express themselves and to experience things. And we thought live 360 video is the perfect medium. We began by doing a series of interviews. And these interviews ranged from people from media and ad executives, to brands, to the regular old Joes, content creators, to content producers, to content consumers. But what we realized, and this was fairly early on in the process, that for people to truly understand what we were doing and what we were talking about and to experience what we were creating, we had to build something and put it in their hands. So we built a simple prototype. And what this prototype could do, it could capture video from a 360 camera and stream it live into a cardboard app or into a web player. Now that we had this prototype, we decided that with a conservative estimate of about 10 million independent creators in the United States itself, let's just put this into the hands of the very people who will be our early adopters. We began with Katie Quinn, a celebrity chef. She has over 150,000 followers on Facebook itself. And what she was really excited about was leveraging this new technology to be able to create a more intimate cooking experience for her fans. And it was truly then that the insights and learning start pouring in. As you can see here, this is just a quick demo of how it looked and how people could interact with her. So what did we learn along the way? We realized that with any new technology, we have to remove all the barriers to entry. Remove the need for the headset to download an app. So we focused our efforts on the web player. All Katie had to do was share a link on her existing social networks, and people could click and log in to view. 360 video itself provides a unique opportunity. It's a 360-degree field of view, and it's unlike the 2D single-perspective views that we're used to. And that means we have to create content that truly utilizes the space. With Katie, what we did was we created her burrito station in a circular pattern around the camera. So what she could do, and what the viewers could do, was follow her around as she went from station to station building out her burrito. And what we realized, and this is something that Katie brought up, was that it would be so amazing and completely important for her to be able to interact with her audience on the fly. So what we did was we built a real-time dashboard, completely integrated with a live chat so she could see what people were saying. But not only that, she could see where they were logging in from. She could see where they were looking, a real-time live heat map to see what they were looking at so that she could alter her catering and her offering on the fly. And all what this ties into is creating unique, good quality content. Content that makes the users and the viewers feel closer to the creator. But ultimately, we do realize that if we want to create value not only for ourselves, but for the creators, we need to find ways to monetize and leverage this unique content. And what we've started doing is successfully experimenting with ways to allow the creator to place 3D objects in this virtual space that viewers can then interact with and link to complementary offerings and content. And Katie loved it. She's already signed up for doing a stream with us every single month. But she wasn't the only one. Ever since then, we've been racking up the stream counts with a focus on indie musicians and artists, and all the while iterating, experimenting, and refining our product. What we've ended up with is a social modular toolkit for creators to be able to create and share their live stream with a single click. So what we are doing is focusing on creating a completely new way for brands and creators to engage and interact with their audience.
A real goal here is to increase the during event conversation and audience engagement. What happens often is creators want to speak to the people that they are streaming to. They want to have that real-time interaction, that real response system. What we're trying to do at the moment is building direct links to products and cross-promotion into our system. How can we use 360 Space to actually create meaningful links to revenue streams? Why is this important to the creator? It's really about direct access to a responsive fan base, both to brands working with them and to their labels, managers, and agents. What's interesting to us is, you know, live streaming is becoming a very important element, specifically of the music and live industries. We see, for example, Coachella, that has sold 400,000 tickets, has 25 times as many live stream viewers. That's over 4 million people watching. Now, out of those, roughly one of four posts on social media are about, you know, people participating remotely. And we think that we have a shot of actually increasing a number and trying to figure out how could we increase that to have more people actually be there in the moment. Where all this leads to is really our vision, and that's to network the audience, to build a community. If about 31% of the audience spends about half of the time on their cell phone device at live events, that is an opportunity for us to create direct links between people that are at an event, people watching 360 live streams at home, and the creator, creating a network between the three. What are the next steps for us as Svrround? The first step we're working on right now is prototyping monetization through live computer vision. That's what Gene is great for. Gene is working on trying to figure out how can we track objects, people, how do they collide, how do they move between the 360 space. The next step for us is also our go-to-market strategy, which we are currently developing, and our beta release this summer, which is pinned at the moment for June. What does that mean for you and their fans? It really means more streams. We're working on a live theater show at the end of April and have more planned with a theater called La Mama in the East Village for the fall. We have more streams of musician Memba, Katie, and many more independent musicians coming up in the next 3 months that we're working with to create great 360 live streaming shows. So our vision of this is to really create a platform that's content-focused, focused on independent musicians and live events for the moment, but then moving on to the further verticals. We want to make it very simple and modular for someone to choose what kind of interactions, what kind of audience response do they want to provide in their 360 live streams. So thank you for listening, and please get in touch. We're very happy and friendly to talk to anybody. Thanks.